Hello to everyone, and welcome to our evening prayer today. Our evening prayer is for today, Sunday, the 25th, I believe, of September. We're almost at the end of September, which is unbelievable to me that this month is going so fast. And then it seems like we get into the real autumn time. October and November, to me, is like the real autumn. So we welcome everyone who's here today, and it's so good for us to be together to pray. We have our candle that's lit here for peace, and it would be nice if all of you could also light a candle. Whatever candle that may be, it doesn't have to be anything fancy. It can just be a little tea light you can light, and we can just all be together in solidarity to light this candle for peace. It's like a little offering for peace. So my peace prayer is from Rabbi Harold Kushner. Let the rain come and wash away the ancient grudges, the bitter hatreds held and nurtured for generations. Let the rain wash away the memory of the hurt and the neglect. Then let the sun come out and fill the sky with rainbows. Let the warmth of the sun heal us wherever we are broken. Let it burn away the fog so that we can see each other clearly, so that we can see beyond the labels, beyond accents, gender, or skin color. Let the warmth and brightness of the sun melt our selfishness, so that we can share the joys and feel the sorrows of our neighbors. And let the light of the sun be so strong that we will all see people as our neighbors. Let the earth, nourished by rain, bring forth flowers to surround us with beauty. And let the mountains teach our hearts to reach upward to heaven. Amen. And now we're getting into our evening prayer. And I would like for us to start by asking for God's assistance so that we can pray, so the Holy Spirit will pray through us. God, come to our assistance. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Now I have a poem for today, which is from Kathleen Lundquist, and it's a translation from an 8th or 9th century hymn, which it was in Latin, O Lux Beata Trinitas, from the Lumen Christi hymnal. O Trinity of blessed light, O unity of princely might, the fiery sun now goes his way. Shed thou within our hearts thy ray. To thee our morning song of praise, to thee our evening prayer we raise. Thy glory suppliant we adore forever and forevermore. All laud to God the Father be, all praise eternal Son to thee. O glory as is ever meet, to God the Holy Paraclete. Amen. And now, as we do every Sunday, we're praying Psalm 110. And this psalm talks about the Messiah as king and priest. And as I say, this psalm is very important to be a psalm that is said every Sunday and also on all major festivals and feast days. The antiphon today is Christ our Lord is a priest forever, like Melchizedek of old. Alleluia. The Lord's revelation to my master, sit on my right. Your foes I will put beneath your feet. The Lord will wield from Zion your scepter of power, rule in the midst of all of your foes. A prince from the day of your birth on the holy mountains, from the womb before the dawn I begot you. The Lord has sworn an oath that he will not change. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The master, standing at your right hand, will shatter kings in the day of his great wrath. He shall drink from the stream by the wayside, and therefore he shall lift up his head. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, bring your kingdom to its fullness. May the perfect offering of your Son, who is the eternal priest, be offered in every place to your name, and make all nations a holy people for you. And the antiphon again is, Christ our Lord is a priest forever, like Melchizedek of old. Alleluia. And now, dear ones, let's pray Psalm 115, which is praising the true God. And the antiphon is, God dwells in highest heaven, and he has power to do all he wills. Alleluia. Not to us, Lord, not to us, but to your name give the glory, for the sake of your love and your truth, lest the heathen say, where is their God? But our God is in the heavens, and he does whatever he wills. Their idols are silver and gold, and the work of human hands. They have mouths, but they cannot speak. They have eyes, but they cannot see. They have ears, but they cannot hear. And they have nostrils, but they cannot smell. With their hands they cannot feel, and with their feet they cannot walk. No sound comes from their throats. Their makers will come to be like them, and so will all who trust in them. Sons of Israel, trust in the Lord. He is your help and your shield. Sons of Aaron, trust in the Lord. He is your help and your shield. You who revere him, trust in the Lord. He is your help and your shield. He remembers all of us, and he will bless us. He will bless the sons of Israel and the sons of Aaron. The Lord will bless those who revere him, the little no less than the great. To you may the Lord grant increase, to you and to all of your children. May you be blessed by the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The heavens belong to the Lord, but the earth he has given to men and women. The dead shall not praise the Lord, nor those who go down into the silence. But we who live bless the Lord now and forever. Amen. Glory to our Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Father, Mother, God, you are the creator and ruler of heaven and earth. You made us in your likeness to subdue the earth and to become good stewards of the earth and to recognize the work of your hands in created beauty. Grant that your children, thus surrounded on all sides by your presence, may live continually praising you throughout, through Christ and with Christ. Amen. And the antiphon again. God dwells in highest heaven, and he has power to do all he wills. Alleluia. And now let's pray a canticle from Revelation, a song from Revelation, the wedding of the Lamb. And we will say, praise God, all you who serve him, both great and small. Alleluia. Alleluia. Salvation, glory, and power to our God. His judgments are honest and true. Alleluia. Alleluia. Sing praise to our God, all you his servants, all who worship him reverently, great and small. Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord, our all-powerful God, is King. Let us rejoice, sing praise, and give him glory. Alleluia. Alleluia. The wedding feast of the Lamb has begun, and his bride is prepared to welcome him. Alleluia. Glory to our Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise God, all you who serve him, both great and small. Alleluia. And now let us listen to a reading from Thessalonians and see what Paul has to say to us today. We are bound to thank God for you always, beloved, because you are the first fruits of those whom God has chosen for salvation, in holiness of spirit and fidelity to truth. He has called you through our preaching of the good news so that you might achieve the glory that is of our Lord Jesus Christ. And our response to this is, our Lord is great and mighty is his power. Our Lord is great and mighty is his power. His wisdom is beyond compare and mighty is his power. Glory to our Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Lord is great, and mighty is his power. Now, dear ones, let us honor Mary by praying her canticle. And the antiphon is, Son, remember the good things you received in your lifetime, and the bad things Lazarus received in his. So let's pray with Mary today, together, as we can all say this, and it can be our prayer as well. Our souls proclaim the greatness of the Lord, and our spirits rejoice in God, our Savior. For he has looked with favor on all of us, his lowly servants. From this day, all generations will call us blessed, for the Almighty has done great things for each of us, and holy is his name. He has mercy on everyone who reveres him in every generation, and he shows the strength of his arm daily in our lives and scatters all of us who are proud in our conceit. He casts down all of us who consider ourselves mighty from our thrones and lifts up all of the humble and lowly. He fills all of us who are hungry with good things, and the rich who have no need of him he sends away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, which is you and I, and he has remembered the promises of mercy that he made daily to our fathers and our mothers, to Abraham and Sarah, and their children forever, up until the present day. And we say, glory to our Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus, who is our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Son, remember the good things you received in your lifetime, and the bad things Lazarus received in his. And now we give our God praise and honor, and we ask that, sustained by our faith, that he would listen to all of our petitions. And our response today is, remember your people, Lord. As the day draws to a close, Son of Justice, we invoke your name upon the whole human race, so that all people may enjoy your never-failing light. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. Preserve the covenant that you have ratified in your blood. Cleanse and sanctify all of your people. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. Remember your assembly that is here today, Lord. We are in your dwelling place. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. Guide travelers along the path of peace and prosperity so that they may reach their destinations in safety and in joy. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. Receive the souls of the dead, Lord, and grant them your favor and the gift of eternal glory. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. We also pray for you, Brother Sean, Brother Rob, the monastery at Storth. We pray for all of our four postulants that are coming into our community on October 4th, the feast of our Holy Father Francis. And we say, remember your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we hold all four of our new members hoping to join Tao on the 4th of October, Brother Richard and Sisters Lisa, Pam, and Sheila. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. With Brother Sean, we hold myself and Sister Elizabeth. And we also pray for all of our little pets, both those that are here with us and also for all everywhere. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. I want to pray for all of my neighbors here in my community, for all the people that surround us And we also pray for the success of a little flea market that we're going to have in the second week of October here. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. We hold with Brother Sean all of our members, past and present, and all who are seeking our Franciscan lifestyle of joy. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. We pray with Brother Sean for Charlottesville and the killings and the all of the things that are happening in North Carolina. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. We pray for all the wonderful weather that we have everywhere right now, and we ask that the Lord give us a wonderful autumn season. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. We pray for you, Sister Sue, and your whole entire family. We ask that God sheds his blessings upon you, and we pray, remember your people, Lord. We pray for the upcoming elections here in the United States, which is only about less than 2 months away. And the first debate between the two candidates will be this Monday. Hopefully, if you're interested somewhere worldwide, maybe you can see some of the debate. So we pray for the upcoming elections and we say, remember your people, Lord. We pray for all people everywhere that have undergone any type of strife, that have no necessities of life, that have no food or no water, no clothing or shelter. We ask that God provide for all of their needs. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. And so we ask that the Lord bless all of us here today, everyone who is not logged in, and bless all of our intentions and everything that's in our hearts right now. Everything that is there, we ask that the Lord bless and take into his heart and make everything right. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. And so we just pray right now in silence, in the silence of our hearts, whatever it is that you want to talk to God. Remember that God is within each of us. He is within the heaven. He's in heaven, and he's within each and every one of us today. So let's just have a moment of silence. We can just talk to God on our own. And we pray, remember your people, Lord. And now together as one family, let us join hands one with the other in love and solidarity to pray for all those that are in our hearts as well as for our world by saying the Our Father, Mother God. So let's begin. Our Father, Mother God, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who've trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, yours is the power, and yours is the glory, now and forever. Amen. May the Lord bless each and every one of us here today, protect everyone from all evil, and bring us all to a fullness of life. Amen. And with Brother Sean, let us not forget all of our six baby doves, all of their six baby doves who were released this afternoon and joined up with the four we released months ago. Pray that they come home, and we definitely will do that. So just for our final blessing. Let me just get it here. May love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. May good and faithful friends be yours wherever you may roam. May peace and plenty bless your world with joy that long endures. May all life's passing seasons bring the best to you and yours. Amen. So thank you for being here today, and pray that we will be together again tomorrow to praise God and to pray for each other and to pray for our world. So thank you again for being here, and namaste.